Today we take time to remember a dear friend we have lost at Rancho Murrieta. Robert Powell's beard has been an inspiration to us all the past 4 years, and it will be dearly missed. Now let's hear from some of the people who personally knew firsthand Robert's beard.
Do I remember the first time I met Robert's beard? Yeah, I remember the first time I met his beard. It was incredible. It was a Tuesday night. We were at church, and I just knew. It was like one of those moments where even in the midst of the moment, I knew right then and there I would never forget this moment. It kind of rivals the birth of my children, my wedding night. Meeting Robert's beard is something that it was a pivotal point in my life. I'm different as a result of having met Robert's beard.
I remember leading worship, and I was going through a rough time, and it was a rough morning, and I look over to my left, and I see Robert's beard just gloriously looking at me and says, "Jeff, you can do this, it's okay."
No.
We used to go places together, and we just had a lot of fun. You know, we were kindred spirits. His beard was red. I'm red.
You know, working with musicians, it can be a battle sometimes during sound checks, especially. But you know, Robert's beard, he's always a consummate professional. I know what it'll be like dealing with Robert without his beard. To be honest with you, I'm not looking forward to it. I'll probably quit.
Being a musician, you dream of playing with the greats. And I knew that when I was sharing that stage with Robert's beard, I was leading with one of the greats.
The most difficult things for me doing ministry with Robert's beard is the fact that you will always play second fiddle to Robert's beard. I mean, you know what it's like to get done with a service and have a family come up to you and say, "Oh, we loved the service. Robert's beard was incredible." You know, and I'm like, I'm seriously thinking to myself, I put hours into preparation. Robert's beard still steals the show. And part of me struggled with bitterness and envy, but honestly, no part of me whatsoever would have said that I want his beard gone because of that. And to be honest with you, I'm kind of left right now trying to cope, thinking there's a beard-shaped hole in my heart, and the only one that can fill it is Robert's beard. It's tough.
I just hope it wasn't Robert who couldn't take all the attention that Robert's beard used to get. I mean, Robert's beard would go before Robert everywhere. Got way more attention, way more popular. Just kind of a fun guy to be around, Robert's beard. I can't.